During the fighting, the armed forces of Democratic Republic of Congo soldiers fled their barracks. After stepping their foot at the border, rebels called Congolese locals who had fled to the Ugandan side to cross back for an address and protection. According to Anita Nakabonyi and Elizabeth Deseng, residents of Karambi in Busanza, the heavy gunfire exchange between government troops and rebels in the area that started in the wee hours of Friday morning forced them to flee to the Ugandan side. Emmanuel Ndekezi, the Mupaka Town Council LC3 chairman, says that fighting has caused mass displacement of civilians. Ndekezi adds that they are very worried that the soldiers may return to recapture the border and the fighting might affect the Ugandan side.
You see, the Congolese, rebels has been fighting there, but without any soldier, because the soldiers were, all of them have been run away. But they have been shot there on their barracks.
Ndekezi father says that due to the heavy gunfire in the morning hours, three primary schools in the town council, that include Mabuyemeru, Gitovu and Muhanguzi, suspended operations and sent all the students back home.
Schools along the borderline in Busanza, mainly Busigi, have been asked to go back home because there was a lot of bomb shelling. And we have agreed the need that the children should go back home until the war settles.
Haj Shafik Sekandi, the Kisoro Resident District Commissioner, says that authorities are on ground to make sure Ugandans remain safe.
Asking our people to remain calm.
Busanza is the second border to be captured by the M23 rebels since fighting started in March this year. On June 13th, rebels captured Bunagana border in Bunagana Town Council after over 150 FARDC soldiers fled to the Ugandan side of Kisoro. By press time, fighting was still ongoing in Rubare and Rumangabo. The Rugari-Rumangabo road had also been cut off by the M23 rebels at Burambo. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.